Welcome to the recap of today's CodeBuddies.org live code hangout. Today, I've been working on a new project. Previously, I set up a scaffold or a quick start project that gives us a way of getting a Django project with a custom user model, Bootstrap, and a register and login and logout flow. Really basic stuff, but you know, it takes like an hour to set that up initially and maybe a little bit more to research that. So I thought it would save a little bit of time. And I created that as a template on GitHub. That means that you can create a project from this project. When you click this button, it'll ask you for the name of the repository. And what it essentially does is copies all the files and creates an initial commit. So it doesn't preserve it in the commit history necessarily, but you do get the file structure in place, so you can feel free to use this template for your to start your own projects. Now, this new product or project that I'm starting working on is a prototype. I'm just wanting to start with some kind of medium fidelity mockups. I've gone through on Canva and created some quick sketches of some user interface ideas for this project, but let's just go ahead and check out what the idea is. It's essentially a group care app where multiple people can coordinate care for a friend or loved one. And you essentially start a group and, you know, in this case, you can specify the person. So it's like a hub in spoke model where people are caring for a common person. You can add members to your care group. And this is all just HTML mockups, so none of the functionality exists yet. And coordinate activities mainly right now. So you can have appointments, for example, shopping, or have group calls, run errands, you know, basic high level categories of activities that you might want to facilitate. That's essentially it so far. And you know, each member of the group can log in and decide whether or not they can participate in an activity. And that way it's not left to just one person to kind of shoulder the responsibility of, you know, their loved one's care. Hopefully the whole group can take, can participate in any way that, you know, they're capable of. If they're, you know, not living in the same city, they might participate in calls, for example. But they could, you know, again, help with errands or just do enriching activities like going for walks in nature or, you know, entertainment and just casual outings. So let's take a look at the code. And it's not very many lines. And we'll just look at how to wire up basic mockups with Django. So really all I've done here is extended this project that already had some accounts URLs with some mockup URL patterns, and each of these just renders a template. And so I created two new templates, one for the groups list and the other for a particular group, and gave them corresponding routes. So there's no dynamic code or any backend database or anything like that. It's just static HTML with Django kind of routing things. The idea is that if these templates come to more full fruition, then we can wire it into a backend and potentially an API and potentially another mobile app framework like Flutter with material design. But one step at a time, just getting the idea into reality a little bit, out of my mind, in a medium fidelity way. You know, not a lot of details, but it does require more work to write the HTML. So the group's listing page is essentially a Bootstrap. Using Bootstrap card essentially for each group. So we go back to the groups there and pulling in some images from Unsplash and specifying the image dimensions and giving it a little bit of rounding, which actually might not be necessary. Let's see how that works. Anyway, I shouldn't be editing the code. I started off with a horizontal card, but it didn't work out for some various reasons. I don't know, top and start. It's not using relative terms anymore. I guess so. We'll leave that in place. And that's about it. So you have the name of your group and maybe a little bit of a description and a button to view the group, which will, you know, ultimately, hopefully dynamically insert the group ID or whatever the URL slug we use. And once you get to the group page, it's just another bunch of Bootstrap components. But what I've done is got a header with a rounded circle unsplash image and the title of the group. So they display cleanly, looks decent. There's a little bit of, maybe I'm not that skilled of a designer, but there's room for improvement on alignment and layout and things like that. But the next thing, we have a row and with two columns, left column and right column with four column width. And this just fills in the rest of the space. A little bit of margin I needed to add for when it gets into mobile view. The left column is the list of activities, and basically each activity is following the same pattern. So I won't go to each of those individually, but it's a card with a card body, and the title is just displaying an icon from these Bootstrap icons, and the participants' photos. I believe that most of the activities will have like a date associated with them, but that could become an optional field. So we're just displaying some muted text with the date there and a button to participate, which would, you know, sensibly add you to the participants list. That way the activities can be group activities like going shopping together or having a group call. And really that's it. So we just repeat that. And the members list is not too complicated either. It's essentially also a card, which I kind of was hesitating whether or not I should use cards for everything. You know, simple heading might suffice here. So I might, instead of having the border box. But anyway, we've got a card, title, and a rounded button, round circle button with just the icon, which hopefully will communicate the point. I can use an alt text perhaps to, when you hover on it, that you can add people to the group. And it'll probably have some kind of an invitation mechanism. I believe the default behavior that is that all the groups should be private. We won't necessarily have a directory of groups, and we'll have some kind of, you know, universally unique ID for each group, so you can't really just guess. And probably an email invitation mechanism. But if we do start to get into a mobile app design framework like Flutter, we might be able to use, you know, phone numbers or something like that and have notifications. But that's much further down the line. First, we've just got to get the idea through various stages of prototyping and ideation and feedback. So I think these static templates can give something visible, somewhat tangible, and get some feedbacks and suggestions for improvement early on. And basically after the, you know, members list and action button, there's just again the rounded circle icons for each of the members. You know, we're displaying them at different size where appropriate in the user interface, but that way we get the people's faces, you know, throughout the app. It makes it feel a little bit personal because it is essentially a you know, we're helping people connect and coordinate and care for one another. So the other aspect of this app is, in addition to the hub and spoke model, so to speak, where a group of people are coming around to the care, providing the care needs for one person, it could be a mutual care group where, you know, a group of friends or family want to make sure that everybody's doing all right. You know, they might be living in different cities or around the world, or, you know, having social distancing issues as we're all experiencing right now. So wanting to check in on each other, you know, schedule calls, maybe hang out every once in a while, you know. So it would be a mutual care group. And I think the model would apply the same, really, instead of, without even probably any substantial changes to the hypothetical data model. Granted, this is all hypothetical. We'll just have a different group avatar, I suppose. Instead of being a person, it would be a group of people, more generically. represented there. But yeah, so there's, I think, some good potential here and very important need to fill with helping each other, you know, through tough times and keeping each other on a healthy track in our lives and looking out for each other's well-being. So I won't go too much longer on this brief introduction to the code session today. But the code is open source on GitHub, so you can check it out. And I'm open to any ideas or suggestions, and so do feel free to drop me a note. This has been a CodeBuddies.org live code hangout. If you'd like to get involved with this or similar groups, stop by CodeBuddies.org. Thanks for your time. Have a great day and stay well.